day in my life as a house sitter staying in Switzerland for free. So I wake up, make my bed, this is the room I'm staying in, and then head to the kitchen to feed these fur babies. I'm sitting for one dog and two cats. And I get to stay here for free because I'm taking care of them. So in the morning after I feed them, I take Tuffy the bulldog out for a walk. Then I make myself some food. And while I'm eating, sometimes Tuffy sings to me.
Singing?
Then I start my day of exploration. So for this sit, Lake Geneva is just a 10-minute walk away, and it's absolutely stunning. I honestly spend most of my day just walking around the lake and taking in the scenery. I'm just thinking about how grateful I am for being here, because I know not everyone gets to spend this much time outside. This is a moment where I realize I'm in a legit painting, and I just feel pure bliss for being able to experience this. Once I realize the sun is going down, I know it's time to head home to check on the gang. I come back inside to show Mr. Churchill some love. He's the most precious cat. Tuffy is hanging out sunbathing and waiting for dinner. Once I feed him, he slurps every bit of it up. I take Tuffy out for his evening walk. He always makes sure to clean up after himself. He's so funny. Then I make myself a sandwich, and it's time for some self-care and relaxation. And that's pretty much it. A day in my life as a house sitter who gets to stay in California wine country for free because I'm taking care of three cats. I get out of bed and head to the kitchen to say hi to Wizard, the indoor cat, and just make sure he's fed and taken care of. I'm truly obsessed with every corner of this house. I think it was beautifully designed, and I just love how cozy it is. Then I decided I wanted to try out the hot tub, so I took a quick dip for sunset. It was just so quiet and so relaxing, and it was truly peaceful listening to the birds chirping and just having the place to myself. Afterwards, I hopped inside for a light dinner, and then I watched the sunset on the property. All in all, I give this house sitting experience a 10 out of 10 because I got to see what it would be like to live life at a completely different pace.
上班有的时候会不小心摸鱼太久，但是一想到自己的薪资，愧疚感就完全消失了，这叫做问心无愧。老板给你安排了很多很多的工作，然后口头给你承诺说以后一定给你涨薪水的，这叫做口是心非。上班的时候我脸上的怨气有多重，取决于我的薪水有多少，这叫做相由心生。每个月初看到自己领的薪水有多少时，都会克制住自己的消费冲动，这叫做随心所欲。明明一个月只拿几千块的薪水，却干了几万块的活，这叫做千辛万苦。不错，今天又摸鱼一天了，我让老板知道，便宜没有好货。
如果你有一个14天的连续上班，你不会感觉到疲劳。第9天开始，你就会认命。
放东西，
一样，好，这个，
这个没有劲啊，
耶。 他就是哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈
只要顾婴儿超爽的啦！一个学妹正在准备护理师的执照考试，她说自己找了一份饮料店的打工，想要赚点生活费。等考完之后，想要跟我一样去月子中心上班，爽爽吹冷气，抱抱婴儿就可以准时下班，还有一份不错的薪水，快乐过爽日子。我听完之后觉得太压抑了，天哪，你怎么会有这种幻想？很多人觉得月子中心收费很高，护理师的待遇一定很好。当初我也是这么认为，后来才发现收入跟一般的上班族没啥两样，班表排轮休。但如果能力不足，只能支援再支援。最常听到就是供体时间四个字，唯一开心的就是准时下班不加班。高学历、急救证书，收入也不会特别高，差别就在执照费了，但是也没有多多少。每天忙里忙外，工作基本的妈妈宝宝身体评估、生命真相检测、接入住跟退宿、补备品、洗碗奶瓶、烘奶瓶。婴儿室消毒，最怕就是遇到恐龙家长，花钱就是大爷令人不舒服的态度，尤其是在疫情当下，不配合的家长只求上帝保佑，不要把病毒带入医院。遇到新手爸妈，交换尿布、洗澡、拍嗝，只能有充分的耐心看他们一步一步学会。然后重点，一个婴儿哭，全部一起哭，他们的感情真的很好。休息的时间微乎其微，有的时候人力不足，更不用说吃饭了，连喝口水都值得感恩。只能说每一行都有辛苦的地方。
今天带你们来看我的跳舞日常。首先拿完衣服在车上换，换好衣服就准备上吉普车啦。爬这个都要很注意，不然就会下小溪啦。都开始的时阵，我们会先到情主家跳几首歌啦。
嘛代表我们要开始准备上班了啦。
然后就开始水蒸拜庙，水蒸拜庙就参照恁平常时看到安尼啦。
啊，这个就是在庙埕拜庙，要准备下班。今天的场比较轻松，我们要准备回家了。最后呢，一样就是到车上换衣服。喵完停，今天的工作就结束。